That's it. That's what it's about. That's what it's about. Hey, welcome to this week's episode. My name is Joon.
And I'm Christine. Let's get ready to rock your biz.
Okay, so today's episode is based on kind of a pretty popular business cliche. In business, you always want to under-promise and over-deliver. I think you and I have experienced a lot of the opposite, where people yes. over-promise, under-deliver. But, you know, for your business success, we want to focus, today's episode is on all the different ways, we're going to help you brainstorm all the different ways that we can think of for you to over-deliver on behalf of your customers.
And the easiest way to do this, just right off the bat, is capturing and finding out their pain points. So why are they coming to you in the first place?
What are they interested about?
Yeah, there's got to be one deep-seated specific reason why, and find that out, because then obviously that's mm-hmm. how you can really start, you know, targeting and gate, you know, just customizing your service or product towards that pain point to help them out.
Yeah, I mean, this is not necessarily a business example, but I mean, technically, as you go to a doctor's office, like for the very first time, or even like a dentist's office, they have you fill out this big, long, like two-page mm-hmm. assessment of your medical history, is what they're trying to figure out, like, you know, different, your history, but they're also trying to figure out why are you here to see this doctor? And the really good ones, you know, they'll go, well, you're here, Christine, for this one thing, but I noticed some other things in here. Have you ever noticed this and this? You know, do you walk this way? Yeah, you might want to start walking a little differently because that might have to do with your back and knee pain. Oh, that's not even what I came to you for. Guess what? You're going to love that doctor.
Exactly.
You're going to feel like they over-delivered. You might not use their terms, but you know they went above and beyond. And that's really what we're talking about.
Yeah, and we just recently ran a Groupon, and what we're trying to do to go above and beyond is we're doing handwritten thank you cards. So when have you ever, first off, you get no thank you.
Exactly.
When you
zero.
Use a Groupon,
here.
They're mean to
we
you.
We took your money. We hate you.
Yeah, they're so mean to you. Like, seriously.
Well, because they're usually pissed because they're getting slammed by all this business at like zero
they
margin.
Suck it up.
Yeah, I know, it's horrible.
Dude, like, you know, I am just going above and beyond even more so. And then they're like blown away because the Groupon users are not used to that kind of treatment.
Yeah.
So they're like, oh my
huge
gosh,
psychological
you're so
advantage.
Nice.
Well done, Christine.
You're
well
so
done.
Nice. Yeah, yeah. And I'm like, but no, but
you're not
truly,
treating us like a secondhand citizen.
But
great.
I shouldn't. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, these are brand new people that are being exposed to our day spa that wouldn't be otherwise. And so I'm thrilled to have them. But yeah, I'm like over the top, like nice.
Right.
And so, but we're doing handwritten thank you cards. And we've gotten an amazing response already back. Because again, who uses a Groupon for some service? So they already prepaid. So they're really not exchanging any money with us.
Right.
Necessarily, but I don't even care. We're handwriting thank
absolutely.
You cards to each and every person. And that, like, people love getting stuff in the mail.
Now, here's the thing with what Christine's saying. If you want to go next level on this kind of stuff, this is what I would do. If I knew, and I try to stay away from that, you know, when we recommend it to people, but if you're going to do a Groupon, get an intern, like, that understands your processes and everything, and make them the Groupon specialist. Right? So that person just greets and just goes all like loves the Groupon people. Hey, I'm just about you. We have our Groupon people are certain kinds of people and just make it this huge experience for them where they feel like, wow, normally you get treated like a stepchild if you walk into someone with a Groupon, or I use restaurant.com all the time. And then, you know, some restaurants are like, you come here every week using this coupon. I'm like, yeah, I'm not coming here without this coupon. I'm that cheap.
Oh,
right?
You can use them every time?
Well, you just buy a whole bunch. Like,
oh,
so on restaurant.com, I wait. This is how cheap I am. You guys are going to laugh. And restaurant.com, once a year, they have a 90% off sale. So, like, you know, so instead of like $5, you're paying like what? Like, you know, less than, you know, like 50 cents or whatever for that. Around 50 cents. So there's no limit. So whenever they get the 90% off, it's usually within 1 week. I buy like $700 worth because they don't expire. In the state of California, they don't expire. In most states, they don't expire. So you just buy a whole bunch of them. I was like, well, I'm like, we just bought like basically $1,000 worth of food for like $700. It's awesome.
Dang.
You know, so anyways, make this like, you know, that's the whole thing. I know what it feels like to be on that end and be like, people are like, really? You know, well, if you have a Groupon specialist, like, wow, they love us. Now, you know, they're not going to have that person forever, but, you know, just deem one of your people a Groupon specialist, because one is it has a separate process, right? You're doing sales differently for the Groupon people. You're trying to do upsells and do intake really well, and you're trying to really wow them. You're doing that a little bit differently than your typical sales and stuff like that. So just, you know, make them specialize in that and knock the ball out of the park, because Groupon is a great lead generation. It's not a good sales
Exactly. It's great for marketing leads. It's not great. It's not sales.
Right. So you need to have someone that's coached into knowing that that's what the purpose is.
Yeah.
Of if someone came
get
with a Groupon.
To walk in the door.
Yeah.
And what's funny is, you know, customer service in America, it absolutely is horrible. It sucks. Like, it's crappy across the board. So it's pretty easy to kind of step
It's not
up.
That hard to be super awesome
no,
in customer
it's
service.
Not.
You know?
It's not, and it disappoints me.
You think of like Zappos. Like, why did people love them? Because they were online, but they were like nice to people.
Yeah.
Really? You were nice? And that was like your, that was your competitive advantage? Yeah. You asked Southwest Airlines, what do they consider competitive advantage? They have a whole bunch of really smart systems built in and pricing structures, but their thing is our people.
Yeah.
That's it? That's your competitive advantage? Yeah, that's it. You think that'd be hard to, you know, you think it wouldn't be that hard to steal someone's lunch if that's their only advantage, but it's hard. Yeah. You know, having treated people the right way, that's really separates you from most of the people in your industry,
and
for sure.
And please don't, you know, your customers are not just a number, not just a name. Like, you need to really take time and learn, you know, personal things about them. Hey, what'd you do this past weekend? You know, hey, going on any fun vacations coming up? Mm-hmm. And then just make those little notes, because, you know, some of you guys have, you're like, how am I ever going to keep that straight? No, you might not, but at least have a system in place where maybe you could put it in the computer, put it on their profile, just a quick little note, so when they come in
there's
the next
like
time,
there's like five free softwares I can think of on top of my head that, you know, you can just set up a Google Doc with an Excel sheet, right? Or spreadsheet on there. It's like not that
just,
hard.
Just
you sort it
in.
By alphabet. It's, you know,
because
like,
then again, you're just going that just that tiny bit more than any other business would, you know. And they're like, wow, they really care. They really know me, you know. And just really, truly take the time to get to know your customers on a different level than just transactional.
And here's why it's such a genius idea, because as you, from their perspective, they just feel like, man, you're going above and beyond getting to know me and valuing who I am. On our end, it's called business intelligence. We're trying to figure out everything they like, anything they might be remotely interested in, not even like what they bought, but why they bought it, because that's where a lot of opportunities for you to just wow them are, you know?
Exactly.
Because if you have a separate mailing list, like, oh, these are the people that did it for this. Well, when we have a workshop that related to that product or that service, they're gonna be people that wanna know about that.
Exactly.
Great. Now, we just technically drove more business for ourselves, but in a way that made them feel like, wow, you really know me and you guys are all about me. This is great.
Exactly, yeah. And just kind of just some random acts of kindness, being gifts or, you know, we like, you know.
Just bonuses, just anything cool.
Just
like,
fun.
You know, yeah,
like,
door prizes.
You. You know. Yeah, and they're just like, whoa, what? You know, how much is this? Oh, bottles of water. This is kind of funny. And then after the fact, I'm like, maybe, I'm always like, maybe I should have charged for bottled water.
No, wait a minute,
Because, I mean, one lady felt so bad, she still gave me money for the bottled water. Complimentary, you know, I would ask people when they come in for our infrared sauna, did you bring, you know, even though we say it on our website, we remind them on the phone, well, hey, did you bring a water container so we can fill it up? You know, we have the reverse osmosis water, we can give you that.
Right.
And we're green. I cringe every time I give a water bottle because I'm like, oh, I hate water bottles. I hate them. But yeah, people forget their water. And then so we, okay, great, I've got one for you. And again, these are Groupon people, and they're kind of like a taken back. They're like, wait, do I need to pay for this bottle of water?
Here's a real-time business improvement. With that idea, because I just heard about that, you're just expressing right now, if because you have green conscious people, whatever, right? If they're going to buy a bottle of water for you, I would say, hey, right now, you know, this is $3, $2 if it goes to rainforest, you know, reforestation in the Amazon. I mean, isn't that what like Starbucks does? Because they're demographic, they know, they care about that kind of stuff. Your people may or may not care about the eco stuff, but if they do, you can use it as a fundraiser for a cause, you know?
But what if they don't have any cash on them? Because they bought these are Groupon
people. Yeah,
credit
card or whatever, you know.
And then put it towards.
Yeah, just I'm just saying it's a way you can offer a service and you can still charge for it, but the reason they're charging for it is a cause.
So no,
I love
that.
They're like, wow, that's great.
I like these little, we should do more of these little real life business improvements.
Yeah, so you're going to hear nothing but Eco Chateau examples for the next 10 years.
Yeah, I know, right?
You know? I'm like, but here's the point. Okay, right now, if you're in a retail business, let me go through your list right now, okay? And I'm going to read off it because we wrote a lot of notes for this. If you're in a retail business, do door prizes. Do stuff where you surprise people. You know, I'm a member of the University Club here in San Diego. It's kind of a bougie kind of thing, you know, uppity kind of place. But guess what? You sit down there, every now and then, the chef will just throw out free appetizers. And you're like, whoa, what's this for? Oh, the chef just wanted to make it for you. No exception to this rule. Anytime I've had a reservation and they saw on the reservation, it's specifically one of my kids, one of my younger kids, there's always something special. So I actually like going with my kids because there's always something cool. You know, like one time we were at a Lakers game, we're at the club up in LA, and, you know, I said, it's been me and my son, and then you put down the age, and they're like, obviously, he's just going to order mac and cheese. It's like the most expensive mac and cheese I've ever bought. It's like, you know, $12 for this super, like, you know, white homemade sauce mac and cheese. But when we got there, he's like, oh, you know, Mr. Han and Junior Mr. Han, like, we want to take him a tour of the kitchen. I've never seen
That's
a kitchen
cool.
at any of the club, but it's because my son was with me, and then they gave him like a chef hat. You know what? That kid is going to be a member for life, right?
Yeah.
Because he loves that experience.
He remembers.
Yeah. So it's just random stuff. Like if I was doing a brick and mortar, I would just randomly do door prizes. Hey, Christine, you're the first person that came through in the next, you know, whatever.
On today, on a Saturday.
I know, you're like, whoa, really? Yeah, you know, I mean, people love that kind of, I think grocery stores should do this all the time. Like, if you're like the 50th person, like, woohoo, free candy bar. I mean, it's a candy bar.
Yeah.
Like, really, what are we talking about at this point, right? So, you know, if you're retail, brick and mortar, do door prizes. Do fun events. Like, and when people come in, choose, like, your best, like, your busiest day and go, hey, we're just doing a fun event. We're doing like a margarita, you know, mixer bar where people with blenders making up margaritas for people or whatever. You know, just whatever kind of fun stuff you want to do. A lot of people are trying to drive business for when a business is dead. But when people are already there, do something fun. Make it like a party atmosphere.
Yeah, we do mimosa Saturdays. So,
oh my gosh.
Yeah. We already do those. It's fun. They're like, wait, what's going on? No, we're just doing it.
Hey, man, what are you talking about? What do you mean? Does there have to be a reason to do something fun?
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Because then you get the whole thing with retail, it's about the experience. Yeah. It's not just about the transaction. It's about, did I like that experience, right? Now, at the very least, and you have a really, I forgot what the name of your system is, but at the very least, have like a loyalty cards kind of system where people are racking
spot
up.
On.
Yeah. What's it called again?
Spot On. Yeah. It's the one we're using.
And it's really cool. It's got this little automated kiosk, and then, you know, they check in there, right?
Yeah. Yep. And then they just rack up spots, which are points.
Yeah. So, yeah. Okay. Now, if you're an online business, this is the kind of stuff that, you know, so definitely online, because they're purchasing online, you can throw in a whole bunch of bonus guides and videos and affiliate offers because that's all accepted in the online space. And this is all like, hey, Christine, you bought this. I just gave you a discount on this other product. Whoa. You know, and of course you're getting, you know, hopefully affiliate like fees based off selling that product, whatnot. Or then you can also say, hey, Christine, if you bought this video, let me show you, or you bought this product, let me show you a video of one of our best case examples of someone who used this to change their life. Anytime in business, you can do like a before and after, you know, that's always powerful. That those are testimonials or highlights. But guess what? Your customers love being in those highlights as well. They love being showcased on social media and being like, wow, I did something awesome.
And for an info product, a lot of them are electronically downloaded. So what we did as a bonus, I've done this with an info product, is we would mail a physical copy in the mail after they ordered it. So again, they order, you pay for it, you got it immediately, great. Well, just as a totally surprise in the mail, you know, a couple days later, they have a physical CD set if they want to listen to the car.
So easy to do.
Yeah. And then they're just blown away. Like, oh my gosh, I didn't pay extra.
Yeah. And here's the thing. There's a calculated risk you got to do. Sometimes you need to offer that kind of stuff so it has great value. Sometimes you totally keep it secret. So for instance, I know for a fact, a company like Zappos, they have this, you know, I think they use FedEx exclusively, whichever one is UPS or FedEx, right, UPS. They have this relationship where, you know, UPS doesn't like empty space in their planes, right? It's just wasted fuel. So they'll say, hey, Zappos, we were able to fit in, we have room for 5 more boxes. And Zappos is like, fine, these things were supposed to be delivered 2 weeks from now, but now they're going to go the next day. So Zappos has that pre-existing relationship, but they don't tell people about that.
Yeah.
What happens though, if your shipment ends up being on that plane, they would send you an email right up, Christine, because you're so awesome, because we love you as a customer, your shoes, instead of coming a week from now, they're coming tomorrow. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, they had to do that. But it's something that they didn't let anyone know about.
That's cool.
So they could throw it out as a bonus, you know, and that kind of stuff. Now, there's another thing along with what you said, Christine. If I'm doing a service delivery business, I do want to really know, why do people buy my service? What are they looking for? All their clear pain points. Fundamentally, for the reason to over-deliver. So for instance, if I know Christine came to me and she's interested in these different things, I can only help her maybe in 2 of her like 5 pain points. But in like a service oriented thing, maybe I keep track of the people that had like pain point number 3, 4, and 5. Well, I'm going to an event that happens to deal with pain point number 3. I'll invite Christine and all the people on the list as my guest.
Nice.
Guess who's gonna love you? The organizer of the event, and then your customers or your clients. They love you for that kind of stuff. And really I don't know about you, but if I'm going to some event that, you know, I don't know anyone there, I like to roll with like a crew of people that kind of like me already, right?
Yeah.
It just makes you feel better. This is why, like, you know, for like awards galas and stuff, I always buy a table because at least I get to populate the table with people that already like me,
yeah.
You know? And then, but think about it, the event organizer, it always comes across as really impressive. They're like, whoa, Christine came to this event, but she brought all these people. Wow, that's amazing. If it's a paid event, go and reach out to the organizer and say, listen, I'm bringing all these people that don't know anything about you. I'm paying for my ticket. Can I bring all of them for free? You know, or can I pay for one more ticket and bring 10 people? You know, usually someone's going to say sure, because it's exposure for the event. You know, and then those, and then your all your invitees, they love that. They're like, wow, you got me a free ticket to this? Yeah, it cost me like $1,000, but you got in for free. People love that kind of stuff. So for services, definitely that, and obviously your newsletters, if they're very informative with like tips on how to use actually what it is they bought from you, that's going above and beyond in that kind of space as well.
And customer appreciation parties, you know, just to have something at a restaurant, you know, maybe partner up, and you could do it on Trade if it's their ideal
client. Trade, gift certificates, yes. All that kind of stuff.
Yeah, gift certificates, Trade, yeah. Or just the exposure, right? So it's a new restaurant maybe, and your demographic of client is like their ideal.
Or there's all these new food trucks popping up all the place.
That'd be fun. They want to roll up in the parking lot.
Yeah, they want to roll up to your place.
But yeah, customer appreciation parties are fun, holiday parties, and just, raffle off some free gifts. Again, just go to the local businesses, gift certificates, donated, and then raffle. People love raffles and they love free food. That's what I've
heard. Yeah, that's pretty much. Well, here's the thing. If you are a brick and mortar, one of the easiest ways for, I mean, again, you might want to think of like what fits the demographic you're coming to, but if it's a place that like a shopping center, go to all the tenants in the shopping center saying, hey, we're throwing this party. Do you want people to know that you're in the shopping center?
Yeah.
I mean, like malls should do this more often. I don't think they'd partner as well together, that kind of stuff. But, you know, definitely when you're, and this is depends on what kind of production value you want. When you're doing an event and people are coming, client appreciation, customer appreciation, you can either ahead of time go, hey, Christina, at 5 o'clock, I just want to interview you a little bit in front of everyone else. Is that okay? You kind of know who you want to pick for that kind of stuff, you know? You could plan that ahead of time, or you can do it when the event, see who comes and go, hey, Christine, so glad to see you. Hey, I wanted to kind of showcase a little bit about, can I ask you a couple questions, and then I'm going to ask you the same questions in front of everyone else. Yeah, that's great. And then we're going to take that video, post it on our social media, and guess what Christine's going to do? She's going to share it with all her friends. Yeah. Or it's going to show up at the very least in your newsfeed and all that kind of stuff. So don't, in this day and age, I think most people, if they love your business, if they got a lot of value out of it, they are willing to be like an informal spokesperson for you just because it's fun.
Yeah.
You know, that's why people use social media. They like being like celebrities. It's all these mini celebrities, right? Like, look at how many people are looking at my post and how many people liked, my stuff. It's a celebrity need in everyone. And again, some people don't like that, but by and large, most people, if they love your business, they would be more than happy to go on record saying, this was awesome. Yeah. You know, as long as you reward it and make it fun.
Yes. So treat your customers like gold, please. That is what makes your business. I mean, obviously your staff, treat them like gold too, but your staff and your clients, without them, you have no business. So I'm really big on that.
Yeah. And again, if anything you can do to separate yourself from the theme for this episode is over deliver.
Yeah.
So anytime you can create you talk about this random acts of kindness. Anytime someone walks away, that was a pleasant surprise. You know, that's what you want. That's your goal. How many times in their interaction with you or in their lifetime, of being your customer, are they pleasantly surprised by things you do?
And I think I learned this from you way back when. The sweetest word to anyone's ears is their own name, their first
absolutely.
Name.
Absolutely.
Is to use their name as much as possible. So that's something I definitely have that down.
Yeah, and your follow-up emails, I try to make it at least 6 times.
That's a lot.
Well, think about it. Okay, in the subject line, that's one.
Yeah.
Right? Hey, Christine, that's two. At the very end, I'm going to say, have a nice week, Christine, right? So it's really only 3 more times. Depends on what you're saying.
How long the email
right?
is.
If you have 2 paragraphs, you can fit 3 in super easy. Cool. You know, so yeah, you do it too much, then it's like, that's really weird. it's like, why are you saying my name so much? It's very spooky. and here's another thing, because, obviously, I come from the B2B services kind of side of things. I'm always trying to figure out my favorite clients, the ones that are referrals for me and a repeat business
and they're cool.
Right, and they're just awesome to work with. I'm always trying to figure out how to build them up. Like, what's a way that I can blow up their business, advertise their business, give them exposure through things that I'm doing?
Oh, yeah.
Because it's not really costing me money, it's costing me effort. But again, these are people that are already sending me referrals, and so I want to recognize that. With our business, back in the day, we never told people they would get some kind of referral fee, because I just thought in our line of business, that's not something you necessarily want to do. So there's some businesses you're actually not allowed to do that. It's like illegal, But even if you're in a business that's regulated and you can't do that, you can still give people exposure. You can highlight them. You can say, this is one of the best people I know and what they do. People never forget stuff like that, And guess what they do? Then stop doing it for them. If they're people that are not grateful for that kind of stuff and they don't show that they're, the pleasant surprise doesn't do anything for them, just cut them off. Nice. You know, don't tell them, but you just don't stop doing. Do it for people that appreciate it.
Yeah.
And see it for what it is. You know. And at the very least, you know, even if you're doing business services, you can still do this like loyalty thing where people are racking up credits where they can redeem them for something that you do. You know, like for me, if someone comes to training events, that gives them a special discount for any future training event. Because like once you're part of my training program, you're part of the family. Yeah. You know, and if you're part of my family, you get exclusive rates. That's just, I would do that for my friends and family quite literally. And so once you've given me your money, you're part of our family. You know, and you're always going to get an exclusive rate going forward. And I think people appreciate that. Then they want to always stay with you, though, because they don't want to ever be seen as outside the family because they don't want to pay the full rates.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, that's
but
true.
Again, but that goes along the same. Well, you say this all the time, Christine, that they've already bought something from me.
Yeah.
So the reality is the acquisition cost is zero now because they've already bought something from me. So now it's a matter of, so even if I shave off some margin on there, I'm actually winning by a lot because in my business, the acquisition cost is pretty high. You know, so to get a repeat customer is huge. And you're talking saving about $6,000 a person. It's a lot of money.
Nice.
For anybody. Anyway, so this was just like a brainstorming session.
Yeah.
If you guys have questions, use the comment section, obviously viewer mail. This is what social media is for, that you can, you know, post and ask us questions. This is one of those topics that we could probably brainstorm all day. And anytime you guys find neat articles about this, go and post it on our post it underneath, you know, this you can't do it on YouTube, but in the social media you can definitely do that. Because this should just be a starting point for you. We've given you as specific and as sometimes universal examples of over-delivering, but we don't know your specific business. You should be super creative in what it is you do. If you're like a dog walker, there's all kinds of extra things you can do that I don't know anything about, you know, but there's tons of ways you can over-deliver, you know, and that kind of stuff. And like Christine was saying, if you're doing a Groupon-driven kind of sales process or lead generation process, you can go above and beyond even in that, right? And just the smallest act of kindness, like,
I know.
It's differentiates you so much in that.
But they're true about that.
I know. As always, go ahead, if you haven't yet, opt in to yourbizrocks.com. There's like two very obvious opt-in forms. Opt in on there because all those bonus materials and our resource pages and all that good stuff available for you there.
And on Facebook and Twitter and Pinterest, you can always check out Your Biz Rocks. And if you guys have friends that are thinking about starting a business or they've just started a business or maybe they're struggling with their current business, tell them about our podcast, right?
Yeah,
I think that's the easiest way to say, hey, check this out. And they can kind of scroll down and pick and choose, you know, what issues maybe they're having in marketing or social media.
Absolutely.
And listen or watch a couple of these episodes and help
this
them out.
This week, just here in San Diego, I met three people. No joke. I met three people that I did not know were watching our show because, you know, we don't know your names and stuff like that. And they're all brand new startups. And they're just like, and it's kind of scary. I'm like, oh man, our stuff better be good. These people are banking their whole business on stuff they learned from us, which is fine. We're pretty comfortable with all the stuff that we're getting. But they're just using it as like their Bible. They're like, this episode, you know, they're like looking at every single one. And then bless their hearts, they're taking notes on each one.
That's awesome.
And the only reason I know that is because they stopped me either informally or formally and they asked like, hey, so in episode 6, you said this, what is that? I'm like, what are you talking about, episode 6? You know, I had to look at, oh, episode 6. And then, you know, and then they're like, well, you said this, what does that mean? That's so great. But you guys should be doing that in comment sections anyways because we can answer those questions.
And other people can even chime in too, and just especially with the social media network. But yeah, and just hopefully no more of my therapists go out and start businesses. They were like, one of my therapists was like, because of your show, I'm going
to
start
inspired
my own
to start my own business. You're like, great.
I emailed June and I was like, this is awesome. Like, that's what I want.
That's
I want to
awesome.
Inspire. I love
but
inspiring
no one that works
people.
For you should be watching
No, I know. No, but yeah. I was like, I love it. I love inspiring people to start businesses. I want everyone to start a business. But I go, but let's not have any more my employees to start businesses.
You just need
I'm like, I'm going to have no employees.
You need
left.
To block that site from your, like, your office or something like that.
It was just cute. It was funny. So anyways, we'll definitely join us again next week to Rock Your Biz.
Bye.
Bye. Hey, Christine here with today's Expert Minute. About a year ago, I actually took a tour of Zappos out in Las Vegas. They will allow you to do it. It's like an hour-long tour of the facility, and Zappos is such an amazing company, and as you guys probably already know, it's the CEO is Tony Hsieh. They were bought out by Amazon a couple years back, but it was really neat to see their culture firsthand and in person. And when I was done with the tour, they actually gave us each a copy of their 2010 culture book. And it's got some amazing testimonials from their staff members and what they love about working there. And it's got pictures of different, you know, company picnics and fun stuff like that. But what really inspired me is just the way they were able to implement such an amazing culture at this company in such a short time. And I was also surprised by the fact that it is a call center. I mean, how many people get excited about working at a call center, right? You know, people are calling, ordering shoes, you know, maybe they're having problems, or, you know, getting the order set up online, so they call them. Again, it is a call center. These people aren't making much per hour, but they love working there. And that was just so very inspiring to see firsthand. They were having so much fun. And it was also really cool to get this book, like right at the end of the tour. They also let us take a group photo because I went there with a group of business owner friends of mine here in San Diego. We took like a field trip. That's the kind of field trips we take. We go to Vegas for like a day, flew out to Vegas, and then came back that night to tour Zappos. And what I decided to do differently in my own business is to really concentrate on making a really fun culture, one that people wanted to be a part of, you know, doing some fun contests with our staff, parties and so forth. You mean, I would like to think I've done that throughout the years, but now I just really want to take it to that next level. And Zappos has inspired me to do that. So again, it's there. You don't necessarily have to go to Vegas to get it, but I'm sure you can find it on eBay or online. It's their 2010 culture book. Very inspiring. And like I said, next time you're in Vegas, I definitely take their free tour of their facility. Thanks. Bye.
Hey, welcome to this week's viewer mail, where Christine and I get 1.56 chances to answer your most pressing business questions. This week's question is very vague, but it's so fun, we still want to give a stab at it. So Gary from New York, okay, this is great, you guys love this. What are some ways to take my business to the next level?
Okay, so it is vague.
How awesome is that?
I don't know if Gary
we should just make up
tons
like the whole episode of like next level.
Just like, I got all this money and I'm going to take it to the next level.
Next level,
are
we talking space? Yes. What are we talking about? Yeah.
But my answer is going to have to do with you will have to have some capital in order to do this and some money. So my answer is not going to be the free answer to take your business to the next level. I would say buying out, if you can possibly buy out your competitor. That was how in 2007, was able to take Cleanology from just doing house cleaning in downtown San Diego to the entire county, because I bought out my competitor, which the irony of that was I was sending him clients for years because we only did downtown, and then I just bought back all my clients.
And you're like, wait a minute. Just take it back.
And I got a killer deal. I mean, you definitely want to do your homework, obviously, and do research, but I mean, that by far took my business to the next level overnight. But, I mean, obviously I had to get a business loan, I had to buy them out, and then you might be sitting there thinking, oh, well, my competitors are not selling right now. Well, doesn't mean
no.
you pick up that phone.
If you talk to every single one of them, you'd be surprised
who's ready to exit.
Some of your most successful ones are like, hey, I want out. I want to monetize my business.
Or they didn't even know they could sell it. Like in their head, oh, I can never sell this business because, you know, then I'm gone and this business can't run. Well, no. I mean, you can run their business because you run the same business. So call, pick up the phone and just
you
chat.
You would be pleasantly surprised who was ready to sell.
So I bought out other smaller companies since then. I mean, that was definitely a large one, but that's my answer, is if you can reach out to your competitors.
Plus, just how cool does that feel? That's got to feel next level, right, Gary? That you're just buying up other competitors. And again, sometimes it's just like, you say there's like five in your region and you bought three of them, and that last one's like, and then they eventually fold anyway, so that's really cool. So here's another one, and again, this one, you don't necessarily need to have capital, but you need to have like some good processes built up. And I would say, if you're trying to say next level, I would say, okay, plan out what's a 6-month campaign, what's a year long like campaign, not a marketing campaign, but a campaign to grow your business. And then for 6 months, you can get, or for a year, just get an army of interns. Depending on what state you're in, and I don't know the New York specific ones, in California, you can't have an unpaid academic intern for something that you used to have a paid position for. The California Labor Commission won't do that. However, if you're doing non-academic interns, so these are just people, think about it, how many people do you know that graduate from college that aren't doing any meaningful work right now? They're not going to be doing meaningful work for the next 3 or 4 years. So just this army of well-educated, eager, wanting to build their resume, skill set, interns, unpaid. Now, for me, you know, the reason you want to build it out for a year, because it's only worth it if you have that much momentum and a big team working with you for a whole year.
Yeah.
So for me, I spent a lot of time figuring out, okay, each individual job description, if I don't have a specific job for them, I don't want them as an intern. I'm very upfront with them. If they're an academic intern, I say, if you don't do a good A-plus job for me, I will not sign off on the hours, and you're not going to get academic credit for this.
Oh.
That makes them work their asses off for you. If they're unpaid, I'm very upfront saying, listen, these are my expectations. If you go above and beyond my expectations, I have a stipend waiting for you at the end. I'm very clear about all that kind of stuff. And the reality is for my interns, especially the unpaid ones, the ones that are already post-college, you know, I have a soft spot for those kind of people. I have a soft spot for leadership development anyways. If they're really good, I will try to help them start their own company or find them a job if they were phenomenal, if they're really good at what they do. So, you know, Gary, that's some next level stuff, because now all of a sudden you got an army of people, and specifically you're bringing them on for a business growth objective,
yeah,
for some kind of campaign or initiative that's going to do that. So, you know, hopefully that makes sense to you. Mm-hmm. And, you know, this is just, I don't know, we could probably just do 5 episodes and just random what we consider next level kind of stuff, but hopefully it helps out, Gary, and we'll catch you guys next time. Bye.